We're live at Skin and D. Johnson Stadium in International Speedway in Barron Gristlejock, Georgia. The Orc Dork cheering section is already in the spirit of things, I can see. They've already dismembered the opposing team's mascot. Nicely done, great fans.
Did you know that being an MFL mascot is the leading cause of death for overqualified college graduates?
This game is going to be a wholesale slaughter. No discounts in the MFL. The team stormed the field. The Brawltimore Razors take on the Orcs of Hazzard. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Grim Blitzrow with you, along with my partner, former player Brickhead Mulligan.
Hi.
And his life partner, the mini mutant head that lives on the shoulder of Bricks Jr.
Hey, you just threw up on my shoulder.
I don't often drink beer, but when I do, I get totally shit-faced. I am the world's most intoxicated man.
Say that again. And it's first and 10. And the defense goes for the jugular and rushes to kill.
It's not how many times you fall. It's how you get back up.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm thinking defibrillators and 100 cc's of adrenaline.
Yeah, they both wouldn't hurt either.
Did somebody say cocaine?
And it's first and 10. Great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
He just picked the receiver's pocket, and the defense gets it. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. Oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
It's 2 yard run before he stopped. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And like a monkey trying to fuck a greased football, he gets away in a hurry. And then catch will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's 1st and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
You can't keep a good mutant down.
And into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's more of a downer's guy than a speed freak, Grim. He's running from his demons, it's clear.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. And it's 1st and 10. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Grim. Oh, my God. A man from prison just came onto the field.
That's the ref, you idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. First down and three. Man, oh man, he hit that line the way your wife hits the all-you-can-eat buffet at Crabapple Tree, Bricks.
You're telling me. She ate 47 Salisbury steaks one time. Thought she had food poisoning. Turns out her low intestines just exploded.
No, that's a relief, because there's nothing worse than food poisoning.
You're telling me.
He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. And the offense has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this outfit.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players have catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and 10. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. Oh, man, he just went off the rails of a crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim. I don't know which way.
The offense has only two quarterbacks remaining on the roster. They better be careful, because when those guys die, it's forfeit city. Second down and a lot. Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and 10. And they stack the line, and he gets his bell rung for a yard. With the vicious kill.
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schwong Galaxy phone.
Yeah. Second down and nine. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? Third down and the punter is warming up. That run is good for 9 yards. It's all about who can control the line of scrimmage on these short yardage fourth down plays. Usually it's the guy with the biggest butt. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Not unless, of course, you kill him.
Wow, look at that free
boom, and he's dead. More to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And it's first and 10. Slipped away like a greased pig. Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and 10. Looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
Second down in a very lot. And that's just a great run for a touchdown. I'll just assume that to Orcs, this is arousing somehow.
Assume all you want and don't make it true.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last three plays! Talk about luck!
The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and 10. Whenever a player gets big like this, reminds me of that Tom Hanks movie.
Philadelphia, good movie.
Oh, with the punishing hit. First and 10. That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game. And it's first and 10. Second down and long.
out! Give us out!
The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Wim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. Other than the funeral expenses, that is.
Third down and tired of the quarterback's tight spirals and magnetic. And the QB evades an onslaught of defenders and lives to die another day.
That was a great movie.
Good game for Tyler. I only need an hour.
Third down and long.
Hot one, hot two,
the quarterback had no time to throw, and the defense gets a big sack. It might make more sense to punt here than attempt a field goal. This is way too long. Well, surprise me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it.
Yeah, man, I was thinking of the title now.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. First down and forever. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. The defender blows up the receiver on the play and knocks the ball loose. Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. Third down and the offense needs a miracle. Kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Oh, nice hit.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? Not too fast. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you.
The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Yeah, well, at least they don't have to forfeit, man.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. And it's first and 10.
Hot one.
Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection.
There's a bloody red head on the field.
No, that's their red penalty marker, Briggs. Looks like this one's coming back. The offense is running low on running backs. They have only two left. They need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. And it's first and 10.
Hot one.
And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two. The ref that just called that penalty, he was convicted of marrying old ladies and stealing their savings.
That sounds like a good job.
He's right at home here, taking money from coaches, players, and fans.
I even saw him swiping money from the bathroom attendant.
Yeah, who don't do that?
Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this.
One, hot two, hot three.
And he rumbles for big yardage on that, and that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. bring up third down and 7.
Hot one.
Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick.
I do. The guy should have fucking caught it.
He's got the distance, and the kick is good. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
Yeah, what about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use their beast boost injection. Close your eyes, Briggs. This is going to get ugly fast. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
And it's first and 10. Oh, and he just turned ginormous! Look out! And he just wrestles away from that.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
Second down and more than the QB would like. Third down and never gonna happen. I like this. They're going for 2.
Seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? You get my grill, I'll ruin your world. Ruin it.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. By the time I got light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. That Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Briggs? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Well, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
He refuses to go down. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
The offense has no running backs left, so they will lose all running plays in their playbook. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the towel.
Yeah, probably have an interception.
He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. And that's a pick six for the defense and a possible electrocution for the quarterback. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. And he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to... Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
A burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably crammed his pants.
And it's first and ten.
Hot. Hot one. Hot two. Hot three.
That ball was almost intercepted. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
Second down and ten.
Hot one, hot two, three.
Oh, mama, just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. The offense has only one quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over.
This new QB, he don't even look too confident. He's pleading with the coach on the sidelines about something.
Yeah, he's telling his coach to punt. What a pussy.
And it's first and ten. You've got to catch that. Holy smokes, he just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Yeah, same as Britch's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex. I took it as a compliment.
The defender says, I don't think so. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
Well, that's a lovely shank for the punter today. He just put his team in the hole. Nicely done. Oh, he just got crushed. And it's first and ten. The defense didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. Second down and ten. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Third down and 10. And that's a run for no gain. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he just lets that one go. He says, no, thank you, and the defense downs it. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. We're back for the second half as the teams line up for the kickoff. The coach told his players they'll be strung up on the goalposts if they don't make this a game in the second half.
That's how you motivate these pricks.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the...
Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. No touchdown today. Looks like that defender ate his bleedies this morning. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
First down and one. And that's the way you play a guy. Nice coverage. And that'll bring up second and one. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So is that cheerleader.
And that'll bring up third and one. He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. Now this should be a chip shot for the kicker.
I thought he was gonna make it.
Yeah, so did his coach. Someone get that shotgun away from him. And it's first and 10. And that's a sack. Oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Lots of blood and guts spilled in this game. The Orcs of Hazzard pulverize the opposition and win by forfeit. There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. An alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game. How about it?
How about if you shut the hell up right now? We go down to the field and listen to what the MVP has to say. Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...